There you go. Hi guys, how's it in the name of Christ? It's Garabo. It's your girl Cranky. I hope you're good. I hope you're peachy. I hope you're stellar. And in a neat little bunch, it's the 24th of October 2023. And everything is still a sight for sore eyes. Yeah. Caveat, let me just put that out there. I'm wearing app makeup, so if it falls off, it's an app. My captions are not always accurate, so please don't allow yourself to be distracted by them. Not only that, but also my with the captions, they have no reverence for God, so they sometimes use a small letter G for God, something I wouldn't do, but I don't have time to edit them, so I just leave them there, but understand it's not me. And sometimes they misinterpret what words I'm saying and they put something down there that don't make sense or that is not like what anything at all that I would say. Okay, now that we've gotten that out the way, rocking up for a third day in a row with my hair out, and I'm doing this because I'm enjoying it. Not only that, I'm tired of wigs. I'm just really, really exhausted with wiggy-ones. Wiggy-ones, wiggy-ones. Wiggy, 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 wiggy. Scoo-wee, wee, wee. Scoo-wee-da-wiggy, wiggy. Wiggy, wiggy, whoa. We're not doing wiggy-ones. Yeah. Anyway, so, I don't really know what to talk about. Or maybe I do. I just don't want to talk about it. God, please bring something to my mind. Listen, guys. You know, at all of this evil all over the show, to me, it's like, okay. Yeah. That's all I feel. At this point, like, okay. Shut up. Well, take your South Africa. Take your America. And run with it looking as dark as it's looking and see how far you get, proper. Okay, so I don't even want to talk about last night's dream because I am nervous that it wasn't even prophecy, but just a distraction. So I don't want to talk about it. Basically, America, as predictably as everybody has speculated, in my dream, had abandoned Israel in this war that they're currently enduring. They had ditched Israel, as in taken away the support, even of the missiles or the tank, whatever, those ships, those whatevers, those war machines that they sent to the Middle East that they've been using to intercept, like, what is this, missiles coming from, is it Lebanon or whatever, to like shoot them in the sky. The deterrence effort that America's walking in right now, they changed their minds and stopped supporting Israel. And in this dream, you know how right now as Americans are torn, they're straddling the fence concerning support of America to the Ukraine, but America is still sending help to the Ukraine? Well, in my dream, they had ditched Israel in a way that they never ditched the Ukraine. And shortly afterwards, America got bombed. And I can't tell you where exactly, but it got bombed and the land was looking desolate. I saw that little mean animal of a pervert walking around, picking up, like, the land was laying flat, desolate, right? There was buildings were down, rubble was on top of people, etc. And this little animal was busy looting or salvaging leftover parts of explosives, trying to, like, I don't know, gather them for whatever reason. Adidoba. Yeah, the little beast, the animal, the pervert, the guy from prison, the weirdo that's all up in my grill with witchcraft. Yeah, the guy that I dated for all of 5 seconds from the US, his, like, things were, maybe God was showing me that that's California that I saw in my dream, but it was mowed to the ground. Buildings, everything was down. It's like a nuke had landed. And that guy, among the few cockroaches that were still surviving, he was like a cockroach that survived a nuclear explosion. He was busy picking up leftover sediment or whatever, you know, yeah, parts. What do they call them? Shrapnel, yeah, for on the floor, but of explosives, yeah, hoping to just take some home. wherever home was, given that they had laid the place down to the ground. I don't know whether or not that was a distraction from the devil or a prophecy from God, because everything happened really quickly. In my dream, I saw what looked like God's extreme potent wrath against the US for ditching Israel when they had very little support from across the world. And instead of allowing Israel to be mowed to the ground and destroyed, he rather destroyed America by causing America's enemies to just shout like bomb. It was just mowed to the, like there was nothing left. And people there were dusty, babuzwa, as in could not believe that this happened overnight. They could not believe that it happened so fast, so quickly, and that the power that they were was just snuffed out from underneath their feet very suddenly. That's what happened in my dream. And I was like, God, I don't want to share this dream, because I mean, it's been speculated that America will ditch Israel. It will not be as supportive of Israel. Not the kind of ditching that I saw in my dream. It was like just guys, like it was from black, it was from night to day type ditching, abandonment of alliances, everything, just an abandonment. In a way that America, the leadership has upset some Americans because of the way that they keep on supporting and fueling financially the war in the Ukraine. They were still helping Ukraine out, but not, they just flipped, like, just like that. Like I said, the ditching of Israel was so hot and cold, night and day, sudden, overnight, that it was frankly a surprise to me to wake up from that dream. Because it's like, it was tactless. The way it happened, it was tactless. It was like sudden overnight withdrawal of all support right in the middle of their operation against Hamas. As Hamas was intensifying, like as the battle in the Middle East, that whole Israeli-Hamas war, as it was happening and Israel was doing what it needed to do, America just suddenly withdrew. Got out of there, like as in skedaddle, took all of its help, just disappeared. Y'all, I don't know, could have been I didn't want to share this. It could have been makanyana, you know, deception, because the devil wants to distract me. I don't know, but it was just sudden the way that America pulled out, and because of how quickly they pulled out, God quickly got them nuked. I don't know where the bomb came from. I don't know who did that to them. I don't know who laid them waste. It was all of a sudden, and it was due to, just in terms of heaven's decision, it happened because God allowed America to be destroyed like this, finished off, because of withdrawing from Israel. And it's the thing that I've been saying right now. What do you call this? America is too lukewarm. It is too seeker sensitive. It is too insensitive. It is too destructive. It is literally trying to finish the world off before the world is ready to be finished off. It's just doing whatever it wants, and it's holding on to its power. And the way that I'm so persecuted and abused right now is America has exacerbated that issue. And I said that like a demon-possessed person, like that beast, that little animal, that ew thing from America, that random that they set free, that's wreaking havoc in my life like this. He was a man that was not a child of God. He was a devil worshiper in the worst way, okay? And he wanted to marry a godly woman. And he pursued one using witchcraft and wreaked havoc in her life from the moment he entered her life. He started to like cast a whole bunch of spells as soon as he was all up in my grill. One minute. As soon as this little beast from the US was all up in my grill, he started using witchcraft on just about everything in my life. He bewitched and like making sure that nobody else loves me, nobody else contacts me. He wanted to be the only person in my space because he knew that he made no sense for me. He knew that he was not in no position to go and take a woman like me. He went and called dibs on a woman that he could not take care of. He could not take care of her, and he did not make sense for her. He was obviously not made for her, but he wanted it anyway. And so he rocked up with Korobela, and upon using Korobela, he then also made sure that any other guy that could distract me from him, he must be warded off. He made sure I don't make any new friends. He made sure that there's nothing and no one that can ever speak sense into me where he's concerned. That's what this animal did, okay? He was not saved at all. And God quickly caused him to develop, what is this, manifest, so that he could not last very long in my life. He could not keep a straight face where I'm concerned. He wanted to keep a straight face, but he couldn't because of the fact that he was so demon possessed when he came into the life of a person that God was obviously looking very dearly. And I used him as an example to describe America right now. how it is that it is this lukewarm nation that used to love God, but it doesn't. It is persecuting Christians in so many regards. It's effectively silencing or smothering believers in the Lord Jesus Christ on social media, making sure they can't speak, they can't do anything. America is standing against the very gospel that it got raised on. It has turned its back on God, and it's casting shadows on people's lives that are of God. It has hurt Christians very severely. It's, you know, the description of Babylon in the Bible says that it's drunk with the blood of saints. It's drunk with the blood of Christians, and America would not like to imagine itself as a country that's drunk with the blood of Christians. But all of the policies that they're pulling from out of their hats and what they're doing with their social media platforms are afflicting Christians. And so the blood of believers is on the hands of America. My blood is about to be spilled because of America. And I said that there is no way that a country or a person can be duplicitous that way. A person can ignore God. Okay, like, whoa, I've got a speech lag over here. I said in that video that there is no way that a person can hold such hostilities against the God of the universe in one area and then work with the God of the universe in another. And Israel is God's land. It's God's chosen destination. Like, you know, people, the Jews are his people. He will ultimately go and get them. And so even though they have rejected him right now, they will ultimately embrace him, and God has got a plan around that land, and everything is centered around that. It is literally, the whole world revolves around Israel. Like, literally the whole world revolves around what's going on in Jerusalem. So for those reasons, it is impossible where it is that the Holy Spirit of God is operating very richly for people who are demon possessed to stay cool, keep their head above water in that environment. They will ultimately manifest demons, just like this guy from the US. As soon as he was in my life, he manifested such bad demons that he had to get out. I apologize for the speech lag. That's just this phone that I have. It's unfortunately just like that. That it is what it is, okay? This guy could not help but manifest demons because he was heavily involved into voodoo. He was heavily involved into all different kinds of different witchcraft. He was a devil worshipper. He was a man that was fellowshipping day and night in rituals with the devil. He could not therefore keep his cool in the presence of a Christian, but he could do nothing but manifest demons. And that's why he was quickly kicked out of my life, because I was filled by the Holy Spirit. I belong to God. That guy didn't. America does not belong to God right now, not anymore. And Israel does. Even if they've rejected their Messiah, they are his first choice. It is what it is. They're always going to get what they need, and they will never be put in a position to not exist anymore. And so because of how duplicitous America is against, for instance, people like me, God is ultimately going to cause the US to manifest so badly that they're going to do a strange thing that the world does not expect. And from the dream that I got, it had pulled out 100% with its back entirely against Israel in a way that it hasn't done that even to the Ukraine. A weird pulling out. A very weird, anomalous pulling out that was unexpected even by the enemies of Israel and the enemies of America. They did not expect it in my dream. Nobody expected them to change like that on Israel. And they did, causing worldwide shock and a pleasant surprise to the surrounding nations around Israel. A pleasant surprise to the enemies of Israel. But a shock out of this world to everybody else. However, the rest of us who are in Christ see it coming, but not at that level. Not at the level that it happened in my dream. In my dream, it was like a sudden and very 180 degree turning back away from Israel, guys. And this particular thing that it did in order for the Lord to spare Israel as a country from being completely decimated by its enemies. He caused rather destruction to come on America, so the world would focus its attention for now on the destruction of America, and that being in order to give Israel basically leg room so that they could fight. Whatever it is that happened, it will happen against America, is obviously going to get a reaction from Europe. It's going to get a reaction from Africa. It's going to get a reaction from the whole world. And if it gets a reaction from the whole world, those that are busy making war in the Middle East against Israel are going to have to stay their weapons. They're going to have to down tools for a season, because it would otherwise be too much calamity globally with what has happened to America. If they continue to fight, it's basically going to cause a temporary ceasefire. The destruction, I don't even want to say America altogether. I don't want to say the destruction of America altogether, because in that it appeared to be the destruction of America, period, all of it. I saw only one geographical location, so it could be just one state, and people were living amidst rubble. And this guy, the animal that wreaked havoc in my life, he was looting or plundering or collecting shrapnel or just parts from a detonated war artillery, whatever, you get my point. Like picking up pieces of a hand grenade and whatnot. It's like he wanted to reassemble his own weapon, because everybody was having to make their own weapons, find gunpowder and shoot, like make their own weapons, because there was nowhere that Americans could go to buy weapons. There was nowhere for them to go to salvage the situation. They suddenly just got destroyed, and now it was every man for himself. Whatever roaches were left after the nuke, they were picking up leftovers. Anyway, maybe the Lord used that animal to show me the remaining people in America that would still be there, to rather display the culture of American hearts right now and how much they have grieved God. The level of lukewarmness, the rebellion, the reason why the Lord would have allowed that to happen to America is pretty much represented by that guy from the US that wreaked havoc in my life. He was a professing Christian, always talking about God, but utterly destructive of the body of Christ. Utterly destructive of the body of Christ. He was a man that claimed to be a Christian, but was just investing all of his dark might in destroying Christians and Christianity, even though he claimed to be a Christian. And currently that's what America is. It is a nation that calls itself a Christian nation. It claims to be a believer, but it is utterly destroying Christians across the world. It has picked a fight with God's children, and it appears to be unceasing and unyielding in this war that it has made. And when you are that way, you suddenly disappear. The Lord hands you over to your reprobate mind. He allows destruction to come to your shores. He no longer protects you. He causes you to be irrational. And so irrational do you become that you start to do things that nobody expects are going to happen. Demon-possessed people are always walking in a way that suggests they've lost their minds. They become so irrational that they're obviously not operating with a sound mind anymore. And so much of what it is that are their deeds now going forward, nobody expects them to come. Nobody expects the next activity on their itinerary to be what it is, because they're operating in so much craziness. They've lost their minds. God hands them over. It's called a reprobate mind. 1 minute. The Bible calls it handing over to a reprobate mind. I apologize for the speech lag. It's just the only phone I have. It does this. So we're dealing. Yeah, the Bible calls people like those reprobates. In other words, they have completely lost the plot. They've completely lost the plot. And in losing the plot, they're like crazy men, just wandering like vagrants, mumbling in their mouths, with nothing really truly comprehensible coming out of there, and nobody takes them too seriously until they've killed a person. Just utterly destructive. Like America has, in the sight of God, from what I saw in that dream, the dream of which I didn't even want to share it, I'm not even giving all the details I saw in it, it was crazy. It had literally lost its mind, because it withdrew from Israel at a time when it needed it most. And now Israel's enemies were salivating at Israel, trying to utterly shatter her. And God was like, I will choose Israel fast and furious, first and foremost, way before I will ever choose the whole of the USA. And that's just what happens to an arrogant or pompous people group who think that no one can ever bring them down, who imagine that nobody can ever stand against them, when they've developed so much pomp that they feel like that they can do whatever they want and completely get away with it. God then chooses a negligible, barely recognizable on a map country versus one that is like an entire continent sitting on its own, like North America. In my dream, God chose Israel over America, because he had no, like, he was lived, it was between Israel and America. in my dream. It was between Israel and America, and God flat out just chose to flatten America, all of it, instead of Israel, because that's God's prophetic timepiece. I didn't want to share that dream because it was so extreme, but I mean, it's not entirely unbiblical, given that America is nowhere to be found in Bible prophecy. In my dream, I saw it like desolate. It was mowed to the ground. I can't really say that it was all of it, all the states, but what I saw was one portion of it, and the little animal that's been wreaking havoc in my life was looting rubble. He was looting rubble trying to make a weapon, because it was like survival mode now for everybody. And I think that maybe the Lord used that little beast in order to show me the current heart of America. It's that reprobate. It is like their little criminal. It is no wonder they're letting him roam the streets free. It is like that beast that came into my life for all of 5 seconds. That guy, as he lukewarm is a very warm word at this point. He's not lukewarm. He's a devil worshiper. He is not going any two ways about it. He is not interested in Jesus. He is more into voodoo than he's ever loved the scriptures. He's a demon-possessed worshiper that is mocking God with his profession of Christianity. And that is currently what apparently, allegedly, is the state of America. A devil-worshipping Christ professor that is actively persecuting the true body of Christ. So I don't know what to do with that. I don't know what to do with that. It was a hard knock dream. I don't know what to do with it. In my dream, it had abandoned Israel, like left it butt naked to its enemies. And God, instead of allowing Israel to fight on its own, all of those armies around it, he rather turned the attention of the world to America by decimating the US. It was my dream. You know, like I said, I'm not the be-all and end-all of prophecy. And the same, guys, so much was happening in that dream. Last night was very eventful. I don't even want to talk about these dreams because, hey, guys, I've been rapping and rapping. Predictably, as the scriptures have said, Damascus was bombed. It was mowed to the ground. It became a ruinous heap. There was lots of gunfire exchange in the Middle East that fulfilled prophecy. And because of Israel's retaliation against the surrounding nations that are wreaking havoc in its life, America just pulled out, and then America got bombed as a result. It got bombed. I can't tell you who bombed it. I can't tell you. But Damascus had been made a ruinous heap. Elam, you know, the Bible says that Elam will suffer the fate of a broken bow. So the nuclear reactor, I would imagine, in Iran, that was bombed. Like, all these prophecies that we're all looking forward to happening any minute now, these end times prophecies, they had been fulfilled. Israel had basically walked in a very short space of time in lockstep with Bible prophecy. All the prophecies that we are currently looking forward to them being fulfilled, they had been fulfilled. And this caused America to turn its back on Israel. Now, okay, like, I don't want to talk about this. You know, like, there are other people, there are better people to listen to when it comes to such prophecies in the scriptures than me, because I'm not that good at it. Like, go listen to Bill Salis. Go listen to Tom Hughes. Go listen to DTBM. People that can really just explain to you end times prophecy in a way that you might be able to comprehend properly. What I saw in my dream, just a war, hard knock war dream. It was a war dream, and Israel was lambasting its enemies. America suddenly just pulled out. It pulled out. It retracted. It took away, like, it removed its soldiers. It took its ships away. It essentially just, like, literally against Israel. And that is the last thing that basically America is standing on. It's the last thing that America has right now, because it has sinned so violently against God, but the Lord has kept it in a bunch somehow for one reason and one reason only. It is able right now to ensconce or protect Israel, and as the world superpower, that is very beneficial for Israel. So the moment America, given how sinful it currently is, abandons Israel, America will then be abandoned by God. It is already on thin ice. It is already like Sodom. I apologize, guys, if there's a speech lag at this point. I really don't care about the speech lag as long as I'm audible. That's what matters. America has sinned so violently against God that it is on stilts. It is on thin ice. It is on a thin sheet of paper, suspended over hellfire. And it will all just plunge into destruction, utter desolation, if at all the fire underneath it reaches that paper. And the gap or the gulf in between that paper and the fire is its stance for Israel. That's the only thing that's left remaining, because it is not held on solid ground by its own righteousness. It has not been kept in a bunch without falling apart because of its righteousness. It has fallen apart. There is a show, like on Netflix right now, The West and Jefela in total. It's become so hard to watch anything on TV anymore if you just want a distraction from what's happening in the world without happening upon an agenda that America started. Like every show you watch, there's a gay kissing scene, a gay lovemaking scene. Like you will be get caught off guard thinking this is healthy, I can watch it. Or never mind gay kissing or gay sex, but you also sometimes just happen upon the insistence of shoving it down society's throat. Every second person in your neighborhood is a closet homosexual, which is just frankly untrue. And these shows make you feel like almost every second person is a closet homosexual. I grew up in a country that's quite free in terms of practicing such things as those. And yet, out of all of the friends that I have gathered for myself, I've only known only two gay guys and not even a single lesbian. And this is out of hundreds of people that I've met all throughout my life. Only two gay guys and no lesbians. I don't know a single lesbian couple ever. Media is making it look as if though in any neighborhood, every third household has either a closet homosexual or somebody that's completely out. And it's just frankly not true. So they're trying to make it true. They're trying to train it into people. They're making people experiment with this agenda so that they will call themselves as members of that colorful agenda. Such that I literally cannot watch TV anymore because of the proliferation of the American ideology in that regard. South African TV is also now insufferable. And really, frankly, the only place where you are almost, you're more or less safe is in countries, is if you watch entertainment from countries. It illegalized that practice. It's still illegal, it's still banned. So a lot of Asian television is still consumable because they haven't fallen into that bandwagon. So now the day's gonna come when on Netflix, all you can watch is KTV. It's Korean entertainment. All you can watch is something from, I don't know, China. Like that, like, yeah. There are, the agenda is not that much pushed in such nations. So you're gonna have to watch maybe like an Arabic show. Like Arabic entertainment, something from the Middle East or whatever. That's all that you can watch now. Because if you insist on watching entertainment from South Africa, it's a show about kids in school, and it'll put this in its agenda. It's a show about medicine, doctors, and it'll put this in the agenda. It's a science fiction show about superheroes, and they'll put this agenda in there somehow. They will go and give a status of the colorful community, alphabet community, to a superhero that all along we've known as straight. You know, that has always just loved women, and then he'll become all of a sudden bisexual or whatever. It is so bad that now you are avoidant even altogether of Netflix or television. And frankly, I personally cannot avoid television entirely because I need something to distract me from the horribleness of the world, because it's all I'm looking at. My life is hard. So I need to be able to switch off for an hour or two every single day and watch entertainment. So I have just finished watching The Flash. It was relatively okay, even though they were introducing this random nonsense. His son had painted fingernails, for crying out loud, and I didn't understand what that was about. But it was consumable all the way up until the last season, The Flash. Now I'm done with The Flash, and I've been hopping from pillar to post on Netflix trying to find something to distract myself. And now there is a show I'm watching, and just on season one, episode 3, I've made a decision to stop watching it because it has introduced... And that's just one other thing. They will proliferate that particular agenda more than anything else. It's a show about time travel, do you understand? And trying to solve a murder across multiple timelines. And there are many couples in that show that are heterosexual. And yet, they insist on showing us the kissing scenes of the two gay guys. And I ended up making a decision that I'm not gonna watch this anymore when they then decided to show like a sex scene of two gay guys. And also, I chose the show because it claims to not have any sex in it. Indeed, it's one of those where you start to see a person, they start to kiss, and then it ends, right? They don't show you everything all the way to the end. I chose watching it for those reasons. It's disturbing enough to just see a kiss and them headed towards the bedroom, evidencing that they're about to go and lay down, for me to be disturbed by that imagery. I can't take it. I don't want to be influenced. I don't want to be trained. So I made a decision to stop watching it. Now, I'm always freaking out and on the edge of my seat, wondering if they're going to disappoint me in season two, if they're going to disappoint me in episode two of season one. Am I going to have to now walk away from every last one? Is there anything left? Must I always just go back to legacy entertainment, stuff from long ago? Like, I'm thoroughly right now thinking about watching, the Big Bang Theory. Even though it's low-key atheistic, it's somewhat safe if you keep your mind in a proper mode. Or watching like something from long ago, like some show that was on TV long ago. Like, that's what now I'm trying to watch, like on repeat, like shows from when I was growing up that are, you know, thankfully on Netflix. That's what it is that I'm facing at present. That is what I'm gawking at present. And it's just so incredibly disturbing that there's no way to run, and we're being lambasted. And frankly, who started it? America. America started this thing, and it spread like wildfire to Europe. It now is in Africa, and it just keeps on grooving into everybody. It is this devil worshipper that is calling itself a Christian, and is shoving agendas down people's throats in a way that is not even representative of true society. In the country where I live, we're relatively free to practice whatever sexuality we have, and yet in my entire life I've only ever known two gay guys, and not even a single lesbian, not even a single person that's bisexual, only two. But according to TV, they apparently are all in the closet. They're all around us. And this is the kind of, like, it's influence, like, it's training by operant conditioning. Like, when you reward certain behavior, it can actually be trained into a person. So they're actually training people to choose this alternative sexuality, this lifestyle. How can I describe it? It's like taking drugs, guys. You don't miss cocaine if at all under heaven you have never taken cocaine. You don't miss it. You don't feel a need to suddenly just get to that drug. You develop a need in you by first experimenting with cocaine. So they are causing experimentation, following causality of that experimentation, of which there then commences addiction to something that you historically never had going on in you. So they are deliberately training lesbianism into people, gayism into people, homosexuality, different alternative sexualities. They're training people by showing it, like shoving it down our faces so much on TV that people think they've always been that way, when it's not true. You know, you haven't always been a drug addict when you check into rehab. At some point, you made a decision to go and take cocaine. And so that's why now you're struggling with an addiction. But you weren't born a cocaine addict, unless your mom was one of those irresponsible crack moms. Then maybe you were born with it, and so you need medication from the time you're born. But nobody is born an addict. They develop an addiction because they experiment with drugs. And so therefore, while I do admit that there are people who from the time they were little kids have felt urges towards the same sex, there are individuals that never had this issue, not even once. And then they watched enough TV and they started to experiment, and now they feel as if though they've always been that way, it was laying dormant in them. No, a drug addiction is not laying dormant in you. You're irresponsible when you experiment with drugs. It has not always been a calling for you to love cocaine. But when now that you love it, do not claim that it was always calling your name. You decided to capitulate to an experimentation with something you know you should not touch. And now you're hooked onto it. People are getting hooked onto alternative sexualities because of media. So when you are turning the planet into addicts of alternative sexualities that God does not approve of, as a nation, you are spat out. As a nation, you are an abomination to God. You are causing the world to become like Sodom. The world is drunk from your fornications, O Babylon. And the US has made consumption of TV on Netflix really hard for me, really hard. I'm having such a tough time choosing shows that I'm having to deliberately opt for stuff that's legacy, that's on Netflix. They've decided to put it up there even though it was airing back before even the video on demand was a thing. I'm having to watch legacy shows, like stuff from long hella long ago, so as to not be like basted by this agenda when people are having to jump through hoops that much in order to avoid temptation, in order to avoid capitulating to temptation, in order to basically gouge out their eyes and cut off their hands, when people have got to work that much harder to flee from the devil, the person who is bringing those offenses is going to be knocked out the way. The Bible says that offenses will come if they're expected, but woe to the man through whom these offenses have come. And America is this thing that is bringing offenses to the world and claiming that we've always been like this. No, we haven't. You trained us evil. You became a cultural beast. You therefore exported your culture to all of the world. All the negative, all the wickedness of your country, you took it everywhere else and then claimed that everybody has always had it in them to be like that. No, we haven't. You taught us evil, America. It's that basic. And now we're addicted to it. Now we don't know whether we're coming or going. And the only thing that America is currently holding on to presently is the fact that it is still low-key able to protect Israel. The day that it forgets that, the day that it abandons that, it's over for it. Because in terms of sin, right now it's being held together with sticky tape. That's what I'm saying. The sins are through the roof, astronomical enough for the Lord to destroy the whole country. But he's not destroying it. Yes, for the sake of the remnant in there, but more than anything for the sake of Israel. For the sake of Israel, he has kept America strong. And the Bible says, when Abraham was talking about the inheritance that God will give him, the Lord guaranteed to him that all nations of the earth will be blessed because of him. And anybody at all that curses him will be cursed. Anybody at all that curses his descendants will be cursed. So South Africa's cursed. That's why the country looks like this. Because it took a stand against Israel long ago. And it is currently pro-Palestine, pro-Hamas. So it is a very judged land that is falling apart. Everything is eroding in South Africa because it hates God. And the only way back to any semblance of a normal nation anymore is a recovery to Jesus. It is a repentance. If they turn their hearts back to the Lord and basically start ignoring the ANC like it's not in the room. Because right now what it is an odorless gas that is colorless, that is lethal, like carbon monoxide. That's what the ANC is in this country. And it has led the country to its demise. It is dying and it will keep on dying unless they repent truly, which it looks like something that's not going to happen any minute now. That's South Africa, a land that is obviously fallen apart and evidences are in its economic state and how it is losing its clout in all of Africa. Very well. South Africa, of which, is also one of the only countries in Africa that has just embraced all manner and kinds of woke ideologies to a point of legalizing all different kinds of woke laws. So it's completely barren of godliness, this country. And any Christian in here is likely very persecuted or about to be persecuted or just lukewarm. It is not serious about God at all. That's this land. I have experienced a severity of attack and abuse at the hands of my countrymen, who all, most of which claimed to be believers in the Lord Jesus Christ. So whenever I listen to a South African rapping on about Jesus, I take it with a pinch of salt. Because every last one I've ever trusted that claimed to be in Christ has turned out to be either a witch or just some violent persecutor of the church. That is evident, therefore, that God has abandoned a nation over to its reprobate mind, and he will only ever cover it again once it repents as a nation. So America has been kept strong, even though it's as evil as it is, for one reason only, given that it only has one thing different from South Africa in its favor: support for Israel. America is no different from South Africa. After meeting that beast of theirs in California, I came to learn as well that Americans are almost as besotted with sorcery as Africans are, as South Africans are. They're into voodoo, men are into bring back lost lava korobela, women are into slapping each other with it in order to, get ahead, careers. They their moral character leaves a lot to be desired. And they also love themselves some darkness. Is that basic? And I should have known that, because I mean, look at how witchy the entertainment industry in America is. So of course, regular Janes and Joes walking up and down corporate America, just dwelling in that country, likely also are as involved and violently so in sorcery as South Africans are. I was tempted to believe that because they're in the West, they're all gentrified, and therefore they don't practice as much witchcraft, anything linked to ancestral worship, all these like lackluster spirits, but they've got their own gentrified version of sorcery. They've got their Freemasonry, they've got their etc. wada wada, plus all of the thanks to globalization, they have inherited African spirituality. This little beast from America has used Jamaican witchcraft against me. He has used voodoo. He has used Haitian witchcraft against me. Voodoo is also largely Haitian. Yeah, he has done all different kinds of weird stuff against me, having lent it from a myriad of witches across the world. So I now know that Americans are also very severely besotted with sorcery, just like Africans, and they have fallen away from their first love and are embracing a lot of rubbish, and are trying to teach people to take by force ideologies that are anti-Christ. In my country, if you're black, if you're like me, you are essentially going to be abandoned to die, suffocate, breathe your last, like bleed out of your nose and out of your mouth. And until you die, pretty much, you are going to be left, even though you are salvageable. If as a black person, you don't embrace your ancestors, people will force you. They will force you, Rolotwasa. They will force you, Royotwala. They will force you to acknowledge your ancestors. Everything that falls apart, they will blame it on the ancestors. When you are struggling to get a job, it's the ancestors. When you're struggling to conceive, it's the ancestors. When you're struggling to pass at school, it's the ancestors. Like proper, they cannot just blame it on the fact that you had a headache on the day before your exam. So in order to proliferate their African spirituality, they will then, when you're struggling, also abandon you because you won't embrace your ancestors. They are on a recruitment drive to make everybody a little devil worshiper just like them. So the Achilles heel of Africa against God is ancestral worship. But the Achilles heel against God of America, the woke ideology, it is the diversity, equity, and inclusion mob. It is the take it or leave it mob that is trying to proliferate a particular agenda down people's throats. And they will push it and push it and push it until kingdom come. And people that don't embrace it are increasingly being ostracized and left for dead. They are left on the side of the street to bleed out. So just like ancestral worship in South Africa, especially against black people, so too is the woke ideology in America against everybody there. So they've got their own thing that they're trying to force down people's throats, that if they don't take it, they basically are facing a future of loss, want, lack, unemployment. That is a nation that is violent against Christians. Why? Because we don't stand with a colorful agenda. We don't stand for diversity, equity, and inclusion at the expense of the gospel. We don't stand for ancestral worship. All of these things that are sins in the scriptures, we believe they're sins, and we call a spade a spade. That's what we do. And so because we're calling a spade as Christians, we are finding ourselves increasingly ostracized in our societies. And if you're a nation that has left people out if they don't embrace an ideology that does not stand with Jesus, you are not a Christian nation on that day, even if you profess yourself as a Christian. Just like South Africa claims it's a Christian, it is not. America also claims it's a Christian, it is not. America, fallen, and it is currently afflicting, abusing literally the global citizenship if they don't stand with a particular agenda. They're smothering our voices, they're censoring us, they're shadow banning us all over the show, making it impossible for us to get heard by the world. When the Lord said that he has sent us as Christians to go and make disciples of all nations, social media is a place, the biggest environment, disciples of all nations. And yet for crying, we are struggling to do that because social media is thwarting our voices. I have said this over and over again, and I will keep saying it. The Lord has called people from all nations to go and be disciples. He has Christianed up the world. He has made Christian nations out of countries that used to be fully pagan in the past. He has succeeded to do that through the gospel, meaning that South Africans can successfully evangelize themselves now. We no longer need the colonizer, meaning that the Ghanaians, the Congolese, can successfully evangelize themselves now. They can send the message out to their own countrymen. They can successfully now be watchmen over their own countries. No longer do we need an Ezekiel or a Hosea from Israel to come and prophesy over our lands. We don't need a Jonah anymore, a Hebrew. But the speech lag, and I like proper, I'm just gonna keep it going because at this point I just like, yeah, that's all I have. That's the only phone I have. We no longer need a Jonah, a Hebrew, coming from the land of God to go and prophesy or be a watchman over Nineveh. We no longer need that to happen. Proper, now God has raised up a Jonah inside Nineveh. A Ninevite can prophesy to Nineveh. But America is still insisting that we get the gospel from them and them only. And it's frankly irresponsible. They're still traveling all over the world to places that have been evangelized. Places that have been reached. Like there's enough young Thomases in that land for Paul to safely leave now and trust that the church will grow because he has handed the baton over to Timothy. He has handed the baton over to Timothy. Many countries across the world are like young Timothy. They got this. going forward. The Lord has trained them up and is therefore now raising prophets among them. Because now a big enough church exists. We no longer need Americans to get on an airplane and evangelize us. Help us learn the gospel. Pierce into our gussies. We don't need it anymore. Yes, there is a need for missionaries to travel to that unreached portion of the world. Get on an airplane by all means and travel all the way there. But do not insist that you be the only people sending the gospel out. And America is currently standing in front of Africans preaching to their own countries. I keep saying I'm trying to talk to South Africa and America is blocking me. I don't care. To reach that little beast in America, I had a dream of him last night. Another dream. Where he was walking on a floor that had my YouTube stats on it, priding himself in himself in the fact that I've got a binary code for views, ones and zeros, priding himself in that. That beast is happy that no one is looking at me, except I don't even care if he should look at me because he's in America. I don't care that he should look at me, and I don't care that his countrymen should look at me. I'm actually trying to talk to South Africans. Like, literally, if you listen to all of my videos, you will hear my heart cry for my country. But not even, South Africans are not hearing me. They're not heeding, they're not catching wind of the message that I am giving. Because America has shadow banned me. It's made sure that I cannot be heard. So God raises up a Timothy in South Africa. And then Paul. That's what America is. America would be the equivalent of a Paul. An apostle that refuses to plant a church in a land. Because he insists on going to all of those lands by himself as the lone ranger that he is. To evangelize them. He is insisting on going into Ephesus by himself, in going into Thyatira by himself, in going into basically Greece by himself, going into all the Gentile nations by himself, and then tells those Gentile nations, I'll be back next week to give you a sermon, but for now I gotta go to Turkey, move from Greece to Turkey and tell the Greeks, move from Greece to Turkey and tell the Greeks en route Turkey that I'll be back in 2 months to pretty much carry on from where I left off. Without handing the baton over to somebody in Greece to now raise up a church, do an apostolic mission in Greece. Now that the baton has been handed over, America is insisting on holding on to the gospel for itself, sending its missionaries. And look, I'm not saying we don't like them, but it is impossible for God, given that he has already evangelized so many countries, to only find willing souls to work for him in the US. Like, there was this young man who recently went to Africa. What's his name? David Maypelo. He's growing quite effervescently. America has allowed him to grow. He's a Christian. He's recently just come back from Africa, okay? To do work there. To evangelize there. Where in Africa, I don't know. But while it is appreciated for David to come to our malls and talk to people and reach them for Christ, it is unacceptable when David is insisting to be the only voice heard, and until such time that he comes back next week again, until such time that he comes back month after next again. It's ridiculous for David to imagine that South Africans cannot do what he does in their own country, or even in a neighboring country, since they're close such as Zimbabwe, than America ever can be. It's irresponsible for America to think that it can proliferate itself and be the only source of understanding or education or instruction to the world, when the Lord has raised up so many other people in other countries to do the exact same thing that the Americans have done. The baton has been handed over. So while we love David Lynn, and we love David Maypelo, and while we love to listen to American preaching, it's entirely unacceptable for us to find nothing but American preachers online, because we have been shadow banned across Africa by America. They're trying to hold on to their power. If at all, you are blocking the gospel mission, which Matthew 24 is about, from the gospel of the peace will be preached to all the nations of the earth, and then the end will come. If you are deliberately blocking that work, there is no use for you anymore. You are a hindrance, you are something that is standing in the way, and you gotta be moved out. And from what I saw in my dream, America just got bombed out the way. It got bombed out the way. It got moved out the way. And you must understand that this YouTube of America, when it loses its ability to take care of it, it's going to be given over to another country. Some other nation is going to buy it. It was predicted, prophesied that Elon Musk is going to, some Christian guy predicted this, that Elon Musk is going to get scooped up by Europe, since America will be worthless now for him to live in. He moved out of Africa and went to America. And this guy got a prophecy where Elon Musk was now permanently residing in Europe, because America was no longer available for him to thrive and spread himself thin in. So they scooped him up. When I heard that prophecy, I was like, what in the world would cause Elon Musk to leave America and get recruited to basically live there, now set up camp there, take all of his family and whatnot and move there and now become a European as opposed to an American? What would cause Elon Musk to do that? It has to have been the destruction of America, and Elon Musk has to have been valuable enough to Europe for them to take him when America gets destroyed. And indeed, if you think about Elon Musk, he is the guy that is currently innovating the Neuralink. And the Neuralink, it is prophesied or predicted or speculated by many people across the world that it is the very beginnings of the mark of the beast. So they're gonna need him for the beast system. So they take him and everything else, they just leave it desolate. So YouTube, this YouTube machine, this Facebook machine, once it has been fried in America, it is prolific enough and with enough people for them to take it over, basically to hand the reins over to other nations, hand the reins over to Europe, another continent altogether, since America is unable to service it, given that it has been desolated. So I keep saying that the US is going to leave me alone and let me pay my, my rental. Let me move out, let me grow my channel, because the Lord showed me that I am going to one day monetize my YouTube channel. And with America being destroyed in my dream, I was like, God, how's that even possible? Because America is literally holding the reins of YouTube. Well, that's just the thing about a company in a land where there is a war. If that company has got branches across the world, once it fizzles out in its homeland, the first come, first served country that will build it up again, fix it, patch it up, now that it's no longer able to operate in its own home country, will then take the reins from there. It'll take the reins from there. So it's starting to look like, while YouTube might one day pay my salary, it's not necessarily YouTube as it stems from America. It will be taken over, just like Elon Musk ultimately will be in the future. And it makes sense why. Because Europe is where it is that the revived Roman Empire is at. That's where the Antichrist is going to hail from. So it just makes all sense. There will be a temporary season of reprieve for persecuted people in terms of censorship, guys. It's gonna come. That's what the Lord showed me. And I always thought that maybe that temporary season of reprieve is going to come because America is going to do better. America is going to change its mind. But from what I saw in my dream last night, America is going to remain stubborn until God bries it out the way. So it must be that their business gets taken over. Their YouTube. I did not see what happens with Facebook, but I certainly saw YouTube changing its mind, doing a different thing. That can only mean management change, strategy change. Now that something big in the world has happened. And so therefore there will be some change of decision. The honchos, the big ones that are making this decision, will no longer be around to make these decisions. And so people are just going to be left to thrive. I told you guys that there will still be censorship against Christian channels, like truth channels. People who preach, prophesy, speak about the news, current events. Those people are going to still remain surveilled and mistreated across the world. But baking channels, fitness, non-truth channels, neutral channels that are non-offensive, they're gonna be left to fly. I am currently shadow banned even on fitness. They're just targeting me for no other reason than the fact that I am garabo. That's what's good. So if at all YouTube gets taken over from America and is now controlled perhaps in Europe by a force there, that force is not going to think to target this phone. Goodness, it just needs to stop giving me so much grief. It's going to make a decision to stop targeting or shadow banning people for dumb reasons. It's just going to take over currently Europe is coming up with some digital control law where they're trying to block what people can say on the rooftops. Control what they say in the spirit of blocking misinformation, etc. So there will always be persecution against truth channels. That's happening. There will be no incentive to continue to persecute people who are brying meat, people who are baking, people who are doing sporting, travel, different kinds of stuff. Like, currently America is targeting individuals, they're targeting Christians. But whoever's going to take it over, it appears, think to do that. They will just leave a baking channel to bake because they won't think to target individuals. They will just target certain voices in certain channels because of what they're saying. So guys, Yazi, this prophecy, this dream that I got, like, it appears to be piecing together now that I'm talking about it. It looks to me like America is going to be slapped out the way, period, because of its betrayal of Israel. And its social media platforms are going to get taken over by another country. And this country will still insist on the mark of the beast. It'll still insist on censorship. It'll still insist on messing with truth channels. But it will not just be lackluster and gratuitous against any other type of content. And right now I've been crying, saying that why in the world has YouTube shadow banned even my fitness? Why have I been targeted even with my fitness? That's not gonna happen when some other nation takes over YouTube. They're gonna leave us to be, insofar as we are neutral and we are nicely obedient to the narrative in the channel. meaning that it will be possible for a person who's got a truth channel that is shadow banned, maybe even demonetized, to however be able to make money because they have a side hustle of baking. Yeah, it turns out from what I saw in my dream, it's not America that makes that decision. It's a previously American platform. The US, it appears, is about to die.